Let's go. What's going on, guys? Welcome to another little episode here. It's not going to be any project today, but I want to introduce my wife. This is Saori. She's my my sweetie, and she helps me out with a lot of the car stuff that I like to do, a lot of the projects and stuff like that. She's going to be a part of some videos here and there. She's from Japan, so she's kind of my ticket into a lot of stuff from Japan, parts from Japan, stuff like that. I've spent a lot of time in Japan with her, so a lot of time to be able to experience the car culture in Japan too. It's really why I love Japanese cars as much as I do. Today we're just taking a little drive. Need to go out and go out to the hardware store and pick up a palm sander. We're going to stop and get a bite to eat at a Vietnamese place, and then we're going to go take a little drive to the American River that I live right next to. So excited to bring you guys along, and I hope you guys will enjoy. Alright, we are on our way. This is the first of many videos like this to come in the future, I'm sure. I'd like it to be that way anyways. Got a lot of projects going on. A lot of hands-on projects, and my palm sander crapped out on me. So, off to the hardware store to get a new palm sander we go. So I figured I'd invite the wife along and make a day of it. Got the day off today, so great opportunity to get out together. As you can see, hopefully, the camera is a little more stable now. Picked up a in-car camera mount, so no more of that wobbly stuff that was going on last time. So sorry about that, but you know, it's kind of how it is when you're starting out, you know, trying things for the first time. It's a process of trial and error, you know, taking care of stuff that doesn't work. So yeah, I got a nice little camera mount. Camera should be working well now. Beautiful day out today. It is, let's say, Tuesday. So as I was saying, I've had the pleasure of being able to spend quite a bit of time in Japan with my wife, and she is from Fukui Prefecture, which is on the west coast, right up against the Sea of Japan. Yeah, I'm not sure how many of you guys have been to Japan, but you know, if you're into cars, that place is paradise. Really amazing, because what you would see here, a car you would consider really nice here over there, is almost like an everyday thing. You see a well-built like FDRX7 or a really nice Supra, well-kept Supra here, it's kind of a big deal, but over there, you know, that's just the norm. They take such good care of their rides over there that you almost never see any cars with body damage or mechanical damage or anything like that. Everything is incredibly clean, and it's really inspiring to me. It really is inspiring and embarrassing, I have to admit, because coming from the US, where you know, you can't go out and take a drive without seeing several cars that look like they're on their last leg, you know, seeing how well taken care of the cars are in Japan, just, it's kind of embarrassing, you know. So personally, I've taken that mentality to heart, and definitely plan on taking care of my Z, you know, having it for a long time. It's a work of art, really. The passion that goes into making these cars in Japan is unmatched, really. So I'm gonna go all down here real quick. It's really something. You guys definitely need to get over to Japan, even if it's just for a little visit. check it out, because the car scene over there is amazing. You'll learn so much about taking care of your cars, you know, what's acceptable and what's not, in my opinion anyways. All right, so we've arrived at the place we're gonna eat at. So like I said, it's a Vietnamese place called Pho ABC, right next to where we live. So we're gonna hop in here, grab a bite, and I'm gonna swing over to the hardware store, which is right next door, and get a palm sander afterwards. All right. Been here before. This place is awesome. Incredible. Pho ABC, Vietnamese Chinese restaurant. And this place actually used to be an old Waffle House. Nice place, nice and comfy. They got the TVs going and stuff like that. It used to be an old, I believe it was called Waffle Square.
Much better now. Never went to the Waffle Square. This has happened for sure.
What are you looking at, babe? What are you looking at? Camera settings. This is where it's at, right here. Charbroiled chicken over rice with salad. Oh my. Thank you. Wow, that's amazing. Wow, babe, that looks pretty good. So I don't know about you guys, but this looks amazing to me.
いただきます.
And just like that, all gone. Not a big cucumber fan, but got everything else taken care of. How you doing, babe? How you doing? Oishii.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Everybody's laughing.
Did you write in the tip correctly?
Yeah.
You did?
What?
He knows.
Oh, haha. I only gave them $2.
That's alright, at least you gave him something.
Because that's a family, it's, I get to write.
So it's the pen's fault, so you deducted a whole dollar in the tip. Ah, nice. Alright, we're gonna skip over to Harbor Freight real quick. Looking sexy. Looking sexy, Xylus. Looking sexy. Alright. Harbor Freight is just skipping a hop away, so we'll go pick up an orbital sander real quick. Come on, what are you doing over there? So this is on sale for $20 right now. It's an orbital, a rotating action. But this one's only $14. Kind of a standard. I don't know. Would like the detailer though. That's pretty nice. I like the point on the front. I'm not too big of a fan of the hook and loop style. Don't really like that. So this one's hook and loop. This one is standard. It's got the metal pins on the side. I don't know, I'm kind of thinking I'll just go with this one.
You know it is Harbor Freight, so I mean, you kind of get what you pay for.
I can't have any filming in the store. Okay. I can't have any filming in the
All right, thank you. There's that too. So.
All right, so I got what I needed. It's just a cheapie, but it'll get the job done. That lady really pissed me off in there, you know. If you're working at a place like that, you need to learn to respect your customers. I mean, you know, it's not like we're trying to steal anything. She got all butt hurt because we had a camera going. Only very briefly at that, but she felt it was her life duty to tell us we can't have any filming in the store several times. She felt like she needed to tell us, even though we turned it off after the first time she told us. Then she said, oh, I'll just go get my manager if you guys aren't gonna turn the camera off. And I was just holding the camera, it wasn't even going. And I don't know, maybe that was just her little episode of feeling like she had some power. I'll tell you what she needs to do is shave her mustache.
Suspension hands it like a champ. set fairly stiff. Actually, it's dialed into a Nice Mosey's settings, which is from a 0 to a 30 dampening setting. It's 12 negative from the maximum 30. So definitely on the stiffer side, and you can feel it, but the ride on air is just a little bit different than the feel of a coilover system. It's very nice. You know, some of the bumps that I'm used to, having driven here for years and years and years, that I'm used to on a coilover system feel much different than on an air lift system. Very happy with my current suspension system. Very happy, to say the least.
All right, we have arrived. Let's go take a walk. All right, here we go. This is a really cool park. It's got the wide open grass area with the soccer nets, which is cool. But my favorite part about it is this little workout area that they provided. It's got some nice pull-up bars, you know, a little plank right there for you to do some dragon flags or some sit-ups, some step-ups, just a nice little array of exercise equipment, totally free of charge. Anybody's welcome to come over here and use it. So occasionally I come over here and get a little workout in when I don't feel like doing it at home. But anyways, here we go. Beautiful area. This is really nice. This is essentially just a long bike trail. It goes for, I don't know exactly how long, but longer than 20 miles, I can tell you that. I've been out here on my bike a few times, found myself doing 20 plus miles on my road bike before I decide to turn back, and it keeps on going beyond that. But yeah, definitely a nice ride for sure. If you're into biking, this place is pretty nice. They got a little school and stuff along the way and water purification equipment over there. And anyways, this leads on about a half mile walk to the water. Sacramento isn't the most entertaining place in the world, but the nice thing about it is that within just a matter of a couple of hours, you got access to pretty much all the tourist spots, a lot of the famous ones in California. Anyways, we're just about an hour and a half out of San Francisco down to the south. Shorter than that if you just want to get to the ocean. Take about an hour drive to the west, and you got yourself at the water. Take a little drive over toward the east, and you got the mountains. Yosemite, about 4 hour drive. Love Yosemite. It's one of my favorite places. Absolutely gorgeous. Isn't that right, babe? You like Yosemite? Yeah. That was one of the first places I took Saori. First time she came to the States before we were married, made it a point to take her to Yosemite. Huge nature, huh? So we love it there. Try to get back there at least every other year or so. See, this is the cool kind of stuff. Along this trail, you can really take the back trails and go through the wilderness, if you will. Really nice. It reminds me of a story I heard about Shigeru Miyamoto from Nintendo, creator of Mario and Zelda and whatnot. I'm sure most of you guys know who I'm talking about. In an interview, he had stated that when he was a kid, his favorite thing to do was to go out into the wilderness and just find little random spots that are seldom explored by the everyday populace. And it was in those little random places, the little caves and the nooks and crannies and stuff that he found out in the wild, that he found his greatest inspiration for what he would later go on to do and create, such as Zelda. And just an amazing story. You know, I think about that every time I get out here and take a walk and find these little hidden areas that, humanity hasn't really touched I think about that. There's so much out here to explore that we don't know about, and this is just one little part of the planet. I mean, can't even imagine what else is out there, but yeah, I can definitely understand how the man was, or the boy, I should say, at the time, was inspired to go on and create what he went on to create. Got a rogue tennis ball. I'll tell you what though, it is warm today. Not deadly warm, but we're probably 90s for sure. And I am not wearing any sun protection. So, this big old forehead of mine right here, yeah, that's gonna happen. My wife, of course, was the smart one. She took the sun protection. She always does. You know, I think it's so important that people get out and they just get some physical activity. Whatever you want to do, whether it's walking or riding, like I said, you know, everybody should get out at least, you know, 3 or 4 times a week just to get some good solid physical activity. I know a lot of people that either work at their desk, at work all day, they're sitting at the desk, and then they're sitting in their car, and then they're sitting down or sleeping at home. And before they even realize it, they've been sitting for like, sitting or laying down for over 20 hours in a day, which is devastating as it starts to stack up day after day. So what I encourage everybody to do is, wherever you live, get out and kind of explore in the immediate area. See what you got around you. And get outside. Really, get outside and enjoy it. The world is a beautiful place. A lot to see. A lot of times there's more to see than you even realize right in your direct area. You might be surprised with what you find. But the big payoff is that you're being active, keeping yourself in shape. You know, they say body in motion stays in motion. And I can tell you, that is definitely true. All right. I am starting to hear some water, so I think we are close. Well, that was interesting. We made it all the way to the river. It was a little farther than we thought. We got there, and I went to whip out my camera. And it was gone. It was not in my pocket where I had put it. So, I told my wife to stay put while I double back. And I found it, thankfully. But not before having to endure the intense heat. I'm shirt unbuttoned status at this point. Still no sunscreen, but at least I found it. All that matters. Time to go reunite with the wife and enjoy this water. Well, the plot thickens. Made my way back to the river, but my wife is not there, so I was gone for a little while, so she may have decided to go out and look for me. Pretty funny, this is kind of turning into a what was supposed to just be a simple little day out at the river has turned very interesting very quickly. So anyway, my guess is that she went back to the car, so that's where I'm headed. Keep you up to date. All right, so we're reunited now and head down to the water finally.
All right, this is what we came here for. There's some nice little drop-off points there for kayaking. Or if you just want to put your feet in the water. I love kayaking too. I don't have a kayak, but it's definitely on my wife and I's plan of things to buy is kayaks. We get out here and enjoy. This river goes for quite a while. I mean, there's all the kayaking you could possibly possibly one out here. It's just gorgeous. Just make sure you got your sunscreen. Beautiful. That's the good old American River. Very nice. What do you think, babe? Beautiful, man. Back in the day, people used to jump from this bridge. It's probably a nice 20-foot drop. But legend has it, there's all kinds of stuff down in this water right here. There's anything from cars to old shoes and TVs. Who knows what else? It's a legend anyways. That's a fish, little baby fish. I think those might be tadpoles, babe. Yeah. Baby frogs. Yeah. How's the water?
Cold.
Cold?
Little cold.
Yeah. Good. Oh, no. What's a good girlfriend or wife if she doesn't splash you, right? When you're out of the water? Mandatory. So my wife thinks that's a fish. I'm pretty sure that's a tadpole. I don't know, what do you guys think? I used to catch tadpoles way back in the day and evolve them all the way up to frogs.
Fish.
On top? I don't know, guys, what do you think? Fish or tadpole? I don't know. I don't even know if you guys can see these things, but all right, babe, you win. All right, well, we enjoyed the water. Not as long as we had intended to. We're going to spend about 10 minutes at the water, but yeah, it's enough. We didn't expect the whole camera ordeal, kind of cut into our day a little bit, but we're going to head back to the car and might stop to get something to eat again, because we already are feeling the hunger. Right. Come on, babe, get those shoes on. Your expensive shoes got holes in them now, I'm sorry. I'll get you some new ones.
No.
American River, kind of, would have been perfect if we hadn't dropped the camera. I hadn't dropped the camera, I should say. Fell right out of my pocket. Don't know how that happened, but it did. But it's all good. Found the camera. Found my wife. All is accounted for. Heights should know this place well. Hey, look at that, there's another Z. That park right next to him. Z fam.
It's a Nazi.
We gotta stick together. He's got blacked out plastic gift emblems. So he kind of knows what's up. It's a DE though, so. Nah, it's still nice. I'm not hating on DEs. Still nice. Come on, let's go. Aren't I supposed to be holding the book for you? And there we go. That looks good. I don't know how many of you guys have ever been to In-N-Out, but you gotta go at least once. Pretty darn good. Maybe not quite everything is cracked up to be, but it's good. No doubt about it. Alright, babe. Here we go. Itadakimasu. So, I know I can't be the only person in the world who loves to dip my fries in my shake. My wife thinks I'm just the craziest person in the world, but I mean, have you ever tried it? I mean, I guess it's definitely not a thing in Japan, but here it's a thing, at least for me. It's hella good. If you guys haven't tried it, give it a try. It's not like eating bugs or anything. Oh, man. In-N-Out. You ready, babe?
Yep.
Let's go home. Alright guys, we are back. I want to thank you so much for coming along with us today. We plan on doing a lot more stuff like this, so if you liked it, come on back and see what we got going in the future. Hope you guys come back for the next one. Talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.